How smart students pay for school. The best way to save for college, get the right loans, and repay debt. Second edition. By Reyna Gobel. Narrated by Meredith Mitchell. Before we begin, please take note. This audio is presented solely for educational and entertainment purposes. The author and publisher are not offering it as legal, accounting, or other professional services advice. While best efforts have been used in preparing this book, the author and publisher make no representations or warranties of any kind and assume no liabilities of any kind. Introduction. Hello, I'm Reyna Gobel. Welcome to How Smart Students Pay for School. I have two master's degrees and know what it's like to live with student loan debt, but I'm lucky to have a manageable payment. I wrote the book, Cliff's Notes Graduation Debt, How to Manage Student Loans and Live Your Life, to help others learn to peacefully coexist with their debt while speeding up the repayment process. Now I'm presenting to you How Smart Students Pay for School, to help students and parents control debt before it happens. With careful planning, you won't have to stress over a payment that doesn't make sense compared to your income. You'll know how to search for scholarships, choose careers and colleges the smart way, and choose repayment plans. Whether you're a high school senior in the midst of selecting a college, already a college student, a parent of a current or future college student, a returning college student, or an in-debt college grad, listening to this audio will save you time and money. All sections discuss budgeting, scholarships, student loans, and taxes, but each highlights the needs of a particular group. Selecting schools is highlighted for college-bound students and parents, while career exploration is a focus for all groups, with the exception of in-debt graduates. I do suggest parents who are returning to school or have their own student loans listen to the returning students portion about new aid, because borrowing for your children's education when you have student loans is similar to a returning student mulling over student loans. College-bound students who took community college courses or college-level examination program tests benefit from the transfer credit section of returning students. Don't worry about jotting down website links as we go. I'm sure you're probably driving in your car or working out at the gym as you're listening. That's why you can find clickable links on the resources page of graduationdebt.org. Part 1. For the college bound. Have you ruled out any university from your list because of the tuition price listed on their website? Don't. The most expensive college may be the one that offers you the most money in grants and scholarships. According to U.S. News & World Report, five of the most prestigious colleges in the country, Princeton, Harvard, Stanford, Yale, and MIT, have over half of their students receiving need-based scholarship and grants, on average, totaling over two-thirds of the price of attendance. That's why the first part of strategizing to pay for college with the least amount of debt is to ignore the university sticker price, that scary price on their website that makes you think you can't attend that university. By the end of the section for students, you will know how to narrow down your list of universities and majors, why you need to fill out the free application for federal student aid, where to find your scholarship chairperson, how to find additional college funding sources, and how to build a budget that includes fun. Let's begin with career focus. There isn't a single way that I know of to make college more expensive than changing majors multiple times or returning to school because you didn't like the career you trained for the first time. Thus, your first task in paying for college is career exploration. If you've known what you want to do, maybe even since you were five, have you solidified your career goals with shadow days, volunteer work, and/or internships? A shadow day is when you spend the day with someone who works in the career field you want to enter. Generally, you'll ask them questions about what their job is like. You'd be surprised how willing professionals are to open up their office to you. When I was pursuing my master's degree, I called up the human resources department of one of the most respected magazines in my state. Within a day, I had an appointment to chat with one of the senior editors about what a career in magazine journalism is like. While I recommend also completing internships, shadow days are a quick way to learn about a career if you're a high school senior in the midst of the college application process or admissions season. Do several shadow days if you can after school. Explore several careers within a career field.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.